Now, moving to our next topic, multiplication. First, a positive integer multiplied by another positive integer gives a positive integer. Next, a positive integer multiplied by a negative integer gives a negative integer. Third, a negative integer multiplied by another negative integer gives a positive integer. For example, positive integer multiplied by positive integer. Suppose we have 2 into 2. This is also positive integer and this is also positive integer. Answer will be 2 multiplied to 4. Answer is positive. Next, a positive integer multiplied by a negative integer gives a negative integer. Suppose we have one integer 3 and another is minus 5. Then we multiply these two numbers. 5 into 3 is equal to 15 plus minus minus. This is a negative integer. Third is, a negative integer multiplied by another negative integer gives a positive integer. Suppose we have two negative integers. 5 multiply minus 5. Minus 5 into minus 5 is equal to 25. Because when we multiply negatives, two negative sign, it becomes positive. So answer is 25. Now, properties of multiplication of integers. First is clear. The product of any two integers is again and integers. That means when we multiply two integers, answer will be also an integer. For example, minus 2 and 4. When we multiply these two integers, answer is minus 8, which is again an integer. Next is commutative property. If A and B are any two integers, then A multiply B is equal to B multiply A. For integer 3 and minus 7, firstly put the value of A 3 and put the value of B minus 7. 7 into 3, 21. Sign negative, that means minus 21. Secondly, take first B and then write A. Again, 7 multiply 3, answer is 21. So, this is our commutative property. Next is associative. If A, B and C are any three integers, then A multiply B, bracket close, multiply C is equal to A multiply bracket B multiply C. Firstly, we multiply A into B, then answer we will get multiply with C. Again, for integers 2, minus 3 and minus 4, we have 2 into minus 3. Firstly, we will do the multiplication of these two numbers, then with minus 4. Answer is 24. Next is multiply B into C, then answer will multiply with 2. Answer is 24. So A multiply B into C is equal to A into B multiply C. Next is distributive property. If A, B and C are any three integers, then A into B plus C is equal to A into B. Next, firstly we multiply A with B, next we multiply with C. Put the sign of positive because B plus C, that's why we write positive sign. For integers minus 7, minus 3 and 2, we have minus 7 into -3 plus 2 is equal to -7. -3 plus 2 -1 plus minus minus is equal to 7. Next, -7 into -3 plus -7 into 2 is equal to 7 into 3, 21. Negative negative cancel, that means positive sign. 7 into 2, 14 plus minus minus is equal to 7. Hence, -7 multiply -3 plus 2 is equal to -7 multiply -3 plus -7 into 2. This is our distributive property. Existence of multiplicative identity. If A is any integer, then A multiply 1 is equal to A or 1 multiply A. The number 1 is known as multiplicative identity. For integer 4, we have 4 multiply 1, answer is 4. If we multiply 1 with 4, then also answer is 4. And for integer minus 3, we have minus 3 multiply 1, answer is minus 3, and 1 multiply minus 3, answer is minus 3. Hence, 1 is a multiplicative identity for integers. Property of 0. For any integer a, we have a multiply 0 is equal to 0, 0 multiply a. When we multiply any number with 0, answer will also be 0. For integer minus 3, if we multiply with 0, answer is 0. And 0 multiply minus 3, answer is always 0. Or if a positive integer 4 multiply with 0, answer is 0. And 0 multiply 4, answer is 0. Now, find the product using suitable properties. First, 26 multiply minus 37 plus minus 37 multiply 74. Minus 37 into 26 plus minus 37 into 74. Which property we can use here? Commutative property. That means A multiply B plus A multiply C. Now, 37, write 37 into 26 plus 74, because 37 is common in both these values. Which property we use here? Distributive property. That means A into B plus C. Now, 37 into, firstly solve this bracket. 74 plus 26 is equal to 100. Now, 37 multiply 100 is equal to minus 3700. Again, minus 17 multiply 102. Minus 17 multiply 102. We write it as 100 plus 2 because 2 is more than 100. That's why we write it 100 plus 2. Which property next? In next step, 17. Firstly, we multiply 17 into 100, then 17 into 2. Minus 17 into 2. This is again distributive property. Minus 17 into 100, minus 1700, plus minus minus 17 multiply 2, 34. Answer is minus 1, 7, 3, 4. Now moving to our next example. A certain freezing process requires the room temperature to be lowered from 30 degree Celsius at the rate of 5 degree Celsius every hour. What will be the room temperature 8 hours after the process begins? In this example, what will we have given? A certain freezing process requires a room temperature to be lowered from 30 degree Celsius at a rate of 5 degree Celsius every hour. What will be the room temperature 8 hours after the process begins? We have to find the room temperature 8 hours after the process begins. Solution: temperature to be lowered by 5 degree Celsius every hour. Load how many temperature load every hour? 5 degree Celsius. Therefore, temperature to be lowered in 8 hours, that means 8 multiply 5 degree Celsius, which is equal to 40 degree Celsius. Now, room temperature in the beginning room temperature is 30 degree Celsius. Therefore, room temperature after 8 hours, that means total temperature minus load temperature, 30 degree Celsius minus 40 degree Celsius, plus minus minus negative term is greater than positive term, that's why we take negative sign, that means minus 10 degree Celsius. Next, moving to our next example, a cement company earns a profit of rupee 8 per bag of white cement sold and a loss of rupee 5 per bag of grey cement sold. Profit of per bag 8 rupee and loss of per bag 5 rupee of grey cement. First part we will to solve. The company sells 3000 bags of white cement and 5000 bags of grey cement in a month. What is its profit or loss? We find its profit and loss. Firstly, profit or loss of the company. Profit 8 rupee per bag, that means how many bags, cement bags sell company? 3000 multiply 8 plus grey bags 5000, loss of grey bags 5 rupee per bag, 5000 multiply minus 5 because we have gained loss, that's why we put a negative sign. 8 into 3000, that means 24000, plus minus minus 5 into 5, 25000. 25000 minus 24000 is equal to minus 1000 rupee. This is a negative answer, that's why there is a net loss of rupee 1000. Next is, what is the number of white cement bags it must sell to have neither profit nor loss if the number of grey bags sold is 6400? Let the number of white cement bags sold for neither profit nor loss be n. Now, 8 multiply n, because we have only given grey bags. 8 multiply n plus minus 5 into 6400 is equal to 0. 8 into n, 8n is equal to plus minus minus. After this step, 8n is equal to minus minus, in another side it is a positive, 5 multiply 6400. 8n is equal to 5 multiply 6400. N is equal to 8 divided by these two numbers. Next step, 8 is 64. Next, 8 multiply 5, 40. Answer is 4000. The company must sell 4000 bags of white cement for no profit, no loss. Now moving to our next topic, division. Division by One keeps the integer unchanged. If an a is any integer, then a divided 1 is equal to a. When we divide any number, any integer by 1, answer is always same. That is, any integer divided by 1 remains as it is. For integer 5, we have 5 divided by 1, answer is 5. And for integer minus 3, we have minus 3 divided by 1 is always minus 3. Next, division of integer by itself. Any non-zero integer a divided by itself gives 1 as the answer, that is a divided by a is equal to 1. For example, for integer minus 2, we have minus 2 divided by minus 2, answer is 1. An integer 3, we have divided 3 divided by 3 is equal to 1. Next example, evaluate the following. Suppose 36 minus 36 divided by 12. Firstly, we solve this bracket, then answer will divided by 3. 13, 36 into 12. 12 divided by 36, answer is minus 3. Then we divide it with 3. Answer is minus 1. Next is minus 7 plus 5 divided by minus 3 plus 1. Firstly, we solve these two brackets, then divided their answer with each other. Minus 7 plus 5, minus 7 plus 5 plus minus, minus, that means 7 minus 5 is equal to 2, minus 2, because negative term is greater than positive term, divided by minus 3 plus 1 plus minus, minus again 3 minus 1 is equal to minus 2. Then minus 2 divided by minus 2, answer is 1, because negative negative cancel, answer is positive. Now moving to our next example. In a class test, 3 marks are awarded for every correct answer. 2 marks are deducted for every incorrect answer. That means if you gave right answer, you will got 3 marks. And if you gave wrong answer, you lost 2 marks for each question. For every incorrect answer, and no marks are given for not attempting a question. Upasna scored 20 marks if she has got 8 correct answer. How many questions has she attempted incorrectly? Marks for 1 correct answer plus 3, because you got 3 marks are awarded for every correct answer. Marks for 1 incorrect answer, that means 2 marks are deducted, minus 2. If C is equal to number of correct answer, C denoted correct answer. I is equal to number of incorrect answer, I is written as incorrect answer. Then 3C minus 2I is equal to marks scored. 3C, 3 multiply correct answer minus 2 multiply incorrect answer equal to marks scored total marks. Marks scored by Upasana is equal to 20, because we have given Upasana scored 20 marks. Number of correct answer 8, because she has got 8 correct answers. 3C minus 2I is equal to marks scored. 3 into 8 correct answer minus 2 into I, because we have to find how many questions she attempted incorrectly. We have not given any incorrect answer, is equal to total scored 20. 8 into 3, 24 minus 20. Next step, 24 minus 2i is equal to 20. In the next step, 24 right here, and left hand side 20 is positive, If we take it right side, it will become to minus 20 is equal to 2i. 24 minus 20 is equal to 4 is equal to 2i. Then 2 is divided by 4. I is equal to 2. Therefore, Upasana attempted two questions incorrectly. For example, filling the blanks. We have to given 45 divided by dash is equal to minus 5. That means which number we want to divide by 45. So we get minus 5 answer. Let's divide 45. Firstly, we start with 3. If we divide 45 with 3, answer will 15. But which answer we want? Minus 5. Take next digit 5. Answer is 15. Next. Nine fives are 45. Answer is 5. But we want minus 5. That means we take minus 9 to got minus 5. Let's take another example. 23 divided by dash. Answer is minus 1. 23 divided by dash and answer is minus 1 divided by minus 23. 23 upon 23, that means answer is minus 1. Now moving to our next topic, order of operation and use of brackets. So far, we have learned the basic fundamental operation of addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. Mathematical expression having only one operation can be simplified starting from left to right as shown. 5 plus 7 plus 6 plus 10 is equal to 28, or 2 into 3 into 4 into 5 is equal to 120. When we have many operations to perform, then simplify as we did in above examples can be quite confusing and may give wrong result. For example, does 24 divided by 6 multiply 2 means firstly 24 divided 6 multiply 2, that means 4 into 2 is equal to 8, or 24 divided by 6 into 2, 24 divided by 12 is equal to 2. In such a situation, we need to use Bode-Mas rule. B means brackets, O means of, D means division, M means multiplication, A means addition, and S means subtraction. Bode-Mas denotes the order of operation to be performed. According to it, first the bracket are solved, then or followed by four operation of division, multiplication, addition and subtraction. The operation cannot be performed in order in which they appear in an expression. That means for if we have given an example, firstly we solve bracket, open the brackets, then we do division, multiplication, third addition and then subtraction. Sequence wise we can do the following question. Next, brackets. Let's learn about different type of bracket used in arithmetic. The brackets are removed in the order mentioned below. Symbol, line, vinculum, bracket, round bracket. Next is curly bracket. Next, square or box brackets. To simplify expression having brackets, the following order is used. If a vinculum is present, then first perform operation under it. If there are brackets within brackets, remove innermost bracket first by doing all calculation inside it. Then solve within the next innermost bracket and so on. Let's clear your doubt with an example. Simplify 36 minus, this is a sign of square bracket, 5 plus, this is a sign of curly bracket, 27 minus, this is a sign of round bracket, 16 minus 9, bracket close, curly bracket and square bracket. Using BODMAS rule and order of brackets. Firstly, 36 minus 5 plus 27, write the statement as same. 36 minus 5 plus 27, firstly solve round bracket, removing round bracket. 16 minus 9, 7. Then removing curly bracket. 36 minus 5 plus 27 minus 7, 20. 36 minus 20 plus 5, 25. Answer is 11. Let's take another example. 14 minus 1 by 2. 13 plus 2 minus 7 plus 5 minus 2 plus 3 bracket close. Firstly, we remove vinculum. 13 plus 2 minus 7 plus 5 minus, this is a sign of vinculum, removing it, 2 plus 3. Remove vinculum. Next, 13 plus 2 minus 7 plus 5 minus, removing round bracket, 3 plus 2, 5, plus minus, minus, removing round bracket. Next step, 13 plus 2 minus, again removing round bracket, plus minus, minus, 5 minus 5, 0, minus 7. Removing round bracket. Next step, 14 minus 1 by 2. Firstly, solve this. 13 plus 2, 15 minus 7. 1 by 2, 15 minus 7, 8. Now, removing curly bracket. Multiply 8. 4 to the 8. That means 14 minus 4 is equal to 10. Now moving to next example, minus 25 plus 12 divided by 9 minus 3. In this, firstly we solve round bracket. Minus 25 plus 12 divided by 9 minus 3, 6. Then what will we do? Addition, division, addition or subtraction. According to BODMAS, firstly bracket of, D means division, next multiplication, then addition, then subtraction. First step we do division. Minus 25 plus 12 divided by 6, 2. Next is एडिशन, माइनस 25 प्लस 2, प्लस माइनस 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 23 इज अवर आंसर।